do, foodies? Welcome back to your girl Kay's Kitchen. And today, guys, I'm coming to you with a meal hack. So it's not gonna be a very long video or whatever, but this is a meal hack. So I was in Sam's and I came across this corn and shrimp chowder, and it just came to me so naturally to make this chowder into a dip. And when I say it was outstanding, this weekend I had a little get together and it was a talk about food because it was thrown with so many flavors, right? So this is how it comes packaged like this, and it's two of these containers, right? And so this is the shrimp and corn chowder from Sam's, right? And so you're gonna stay tuned and watch me put this together. And when I say it's quick, fast meal, it really is. I'm gonna saute me some shrimps. I got this pan right here going right now. So guys, stay with me and see how I put this thing together, all right? Welcome to Kay's Kitchen. All right, y'all. So here's my shrimps over here. And from the last time I made shrimps, I let you guys know that this is my little new way of how I like to do my shrimps. One by one in the pan. And so I'm gonna do this until it's all my shrimp are cooked. And then I'll show you how I layer it with everything else. All right, y'all, so these are the large shrimps. So I'm gonna let them go like 3 to 4 minutes on each side, and I'll flip it. So once this back side is done, I'll flip him over, okay? And now these shrimps, I had seasoned them prior to even starting the video, and all I have in there is some obey, some garlic powder, onion powder, and some black pepper that's in here, okay? All right, foodies, I'm to the last batch of my shrimps. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and take these babies out. They are so beautiful. And I'm gonna continue with my corn and shrimp chowder dip, all right? So to this pot, next what I'm gonna add to it is some garlic, some onions. You'll see I'll add these shrimps back in here. I'll saute it up just a little bit together, and then I'll go ahead and add the corn and shrimp chowder that you seen I showed you the package of, okay? So to this is one whole onion. All right, so it's like how much garlic you like, right? Y'all know me, I cook with a good amount of garlic. So that's about a tablespoon. Maybe a tablespoon and a half. A garlic. So one whole onion. And then I got like 1 tablespoon of butter that I'm also gonna put in here, all right? So 1 tablespoon of butter. All right, y'all, I just put in the corn chowder All right, it was just one container. It's gonna be three containers total that I put in here, all right? For time purposes, I already have two of the containers pre-warming already, and this is a handy dandy pot right here, right? So I can speed this process up, all right? So I got three going, three of these containers I'm gonna have inside my dip along with all these shrimps that I have in here. To that, I'm gonna add some obey. I'm gonna add you some obey in there, all right? Just a little sprinkle, zazz it up a little bit. And I got some smoked paprika going in there. Smoked Gouda. Smoked Gouda. I'll turn the stove off because the heat from the stove will go ahead and begin to melt this smoked Gouda. Alright guys, now from here what I'm going to do is I'm going to add this to my crock pot. Okay, because this is a dip. I'm gonna add it to my crock pot, and yes, this is gonna thicken up. I'm gonna add some more cheese to this. And so you see how I added the smoked Gouda? Go ahead and add whatever kind of cheese your family likes. So this is some smoked Gouda, and I'm gonna add some mild cheddar once I get it into the crock pot, all right? And it's gonna thicken up really well from there. Gorgeous hunk of beauty going down in this crock pot. This is my other two containers of the sauce that I'll be pouring in this crock pot. And we don't even need all three of them. So just count it as two. Just two, because three of them is just too much. All right? So just count that as two. And I almost forgot some bacon bits. We're gonna add some bacon bits into this, all right? As much as you like. Stir it around. So this is some cheese I have right here on the top of it. And I'll just leave this. I have this on my high, and I'll let this go for maybe like another 30 minutes, but it's done. It's done, all right? Thank you for joining your girl Kay in this kitchen tonight, guys. It was a very quick meal that I made. Like I said, it's a corn and shrimp chowder dip. So I turned this chowder into a dip. And to that dip, just some simple chips. Whatever chips you like, I'll be using this to dip in that chowder that you've seen. This weekend we had it with some, what do we have with some sliders, I believe we had it with. So you can pair it with whatever you like, but this definitely is an appetizer, a finger food. your friends, your family will enjoy it. So guys, thank you for tuning in with your girl Kay again. Do like, share, subscribe, leave me a comment. Let me know how this dish worked out for you. Was it a raving fan for your friends and your family? Did you like it at game time? Tune in for next time and come cook with Kay, guys. Have a blessed day.